can bring forth bad fruit, which would represent our sin or our corrupted thinking. Today, I just want to deal with a healthy tree.
Yes.
To be really healthy, what it is to be really, really healthy. So we see here, we could not have life without a mind. I really want to take my time and I want to break it down. I really want you all to understand what I'm really trying to say about the mind. With just having a lip or a soul or just a body or a being, a human being, without the Spirit of God or without breath in our body, we are nothing. We cannot have life without a mind. We have seen many a times where folk have lost their mind. And they're just literally, they'll sit there. You need somebody to think for you. You need somebody to take care of you, to make sure to govern you. But because you have your own mind, it's not an excuse for circumstances to allow you to act any old kind of way, to cause you to bring forth any kind of fruit because of the circumstance or because of what people have done to you. So without life and without a mind, you're nothing. So because we have life and because we have mind, which here the fruit would represent the mind, or even the tree would represent the mind or the heart of man, but the fruit in the Jewish metaphor or Jewish terms represent character and conduct.
Ooh.
So that's why he connects the tree and the fruit, because with the tree of me being a being, I have the rulership over my life to bring forth good character and good conduct.
That's right.
No matter who did what, again, I want to keep going there. It doesn't matter about how you were brought up and what mama and daddy did to you. When you get old enough to become is what really a man is. It's not about what you present to us. It's not about how you act in front of us. It's about your thoughts are attracting your really your circumstances, your environment, and all of that. Your thoughts.
Yes.
You are the ruler of your mind. That's the whole thing I just want to get in your mind today. And until you start thinking right, it does not produce a good fruit if your thoughts are not right. If your thoughts are bad, or if you sour all the time, don't you just understand? You know these people get them walk around sour. They lurking and looking for something. That's because they have sour thoughts.
That's right.
Angry, bitter. Always trying to check somebody. That's because they're bitter and they're angry. You only can become or produce what your thoughts are. This is the only thing God was trying to get them to see. And then when you go up into the 15th verse and it talks about the false prophets and the wolves, basically he was warning us about church folk that be in the church and still lying to their own self. So
God. Wow.
The work of
Come on, come on.
It'll tell you for real if you don't think right.